guys, what is going on? My name is Brian, and today we are here coming back with yet another video because you guys could apparently not freaking wait. Welcome back to American Reacts to Swedish Music, Part 4. Alright, my friends, so I got good news and bad news all at once. Which one do you want to hear first? I'm assuming most of you guys are saying bad news. Sometimes you got to get the caca out of the way so you can enjoy the rest of life, right? So the bad news is that I know several of you have been recommending several musicians, and trust me, I am reading the comments, so I wanted to just give you guys the heads up. With that being said, several of the musicians that you guys have been recommending are so freaking popular that one, they're either blocked completely off of YouTube, or two, that even though they're Swedish musicians, they're blocked in Sweden. What a quinkadink. Some of those musicians do include Swedish House Mafia, Roxette, and Gyllene Tider, and forgive me if I mispronounce their name, it's authentic Swedish words, and as you guys know, I'm not Swedish. But it's also pretty funny because apparently you guys get joy out of seeing me mispronounce things. So, thank you, Sweden. But on the bright side, my friends, Sweden apparently has so many goddamn musicians that, fun fact, apparently one out of every 10 is a pop star. This is my very first time that I am covering a country that has an infinite amount of musicians just lined up, ready to go, and with that being said, we were able to put together quite the amazing list. So all right, my Swedish friends, prepare your IKEAs. Let's go for this. So as always, make sure you check out the Instagram page. It is linked right down there. You can definitely send me a message and let me know what you thought or what was your favorite musician on this list. But up first, we currently got Roblyn with the song, Dance on My Own. Let's check it out. Shaking uncontrollably. I like it. Does she love you better than I can? It's a big black sky over my town. Okay. I know where you at. I bet she's around. I'm waiting for that sauce. Empowerment, bro. I'm just gonna dance all night. It's a very odd music video. I'm so out of line. Stilettos and broken bottles. I'm spinning around in circles. I'm in the corner watching you kiss. I have mixed feelings about this, actually. Let's stop it right here. Alright, so I gotta give it to Roblyn. She has a lot of power, a lot of movement. She's very energetic, in your face type deal, if you get what I mean. What I can't get over is the very odd, it sounds almost tacky to an extent, and I feel very bad saying that, but the background, it just sounds like the I don't know. I could do some of it, but it's very consistent throughout the song. It's actually very prominent. I personally can see a lot of potential in her, so I want to see maybe some additional music that she has made. But for this one, I'm a little bit against the ropes, all right? But I really gotta give her some massive amount of credit. I know she's built quite the empire over there in Sweden and in several countries from around the world. So big kudos to you. With that being said, Roblyn, I'm so sorry. Don't kill me, please. We could become friends, all right? I gotta give you a 7 out of 10. Alright, my friends, so up next, we currently got a musician named Elliphant with the song Spoon Me, and apparently it's also featuring Skrillex, so, you know, you gotta put some dubstep in there, right? Alright, Sweden, let's do this. Wow, that's attractive. Trip on fast lovers back on get with me. Looking down hard to find an easy way. Easy way. I gotta walk my demons, need a fresh eye. Keep them in a leash, then my strong. I don't know why I love it when people slur their words. I love what Skrillex and this young lady did together. Oh my lord. Do yourself a favor and wear some headphones. How have I never heard of Elliphant before? I love it. I don't know why, but I absolutely love this young lady. Actually, you know what? I think I do know why. I love her combination with like the slurred words. I love what's going on with like her rhythm, mind you, especially when you're working together with like these type of musicians such as Skrillex. Like, you both put together such a creative power and like minds together that you come out with pretty awesome music such as this. I don't know if I'm the only person getting this type of vibe, but she kind of reminds me of Mo, the Danish singer. You guys might recognize her from Major Lazer, Lean On. She was featured on the track and she was like the main voice through there. She kind of has a similar like wardrobe, like very colorful, very vibrant, and she's really sticking it to the man. I am completely in disbelief that I have never heard of Elliphant in the past. She's absolutely phenomenal and it is going into my personal playlist. This is a 10 out of 10. Right, my friends, before we move on to our next musician, I wanted to give you a quick announcement. It won't take me long. Down in the description box, you're actually going to be able to find some of my social media pages where we could communicate back and forth, and even a Patreon page, which allows you to support what's going on here on this channel. There are several perks on there, such as early access to videos or even shoutouts. So make sure you check into them. Let me know if you have any questions. I will try my best to answer them. But our next musician is a very, very popular musician that I'm actually very shocked to see on this list. I had no idea he was Swedish, but I'm so proud that he made it on here. But up next, we got Alesso with his song, Remedy. Let's check it out. By the way, I do know this song and I'm a big fan of it. I'm just realizing I have never seen the music video. Not gonna lie, that's a pretty cute ass costume. It's so good. Why? It's unbelievable how much reach this music has. Oh man, it's absolutely a phenomenal song. I got nothing but good things to say. This was my very first time seeing the music video, and it's kind of disheartening seeing this little alien, this young boy, just holding his hand in the park and stuff like that. But anyways, let's dive right into the music. I'm not the world's biggest fan of EDM, but Alesso definitely has made it in, along with several other EDM artists that have come out straight from Sweden. So I don't usually listen to the radio, but when it gets to that point when it goes past radio and it somehow makes its way into my laps, I know it's a big song. So how does this usually happen, you might be asking? Good question. So I actually work in retail and I am out to the speaker, so I'm listening to everything that our store is playing. Alesso has somehow managed to get this oversized corporation to play their music and everything. I mind you, it's very exclusive to get onto these stores, like very, very exclusive. So whenever I hear musicians there, I know they made it. And Alesso, of course, has had their music there. What I'm saying is that this is an easy million out of 10. Is it too many numbers? Can my editor even type that many numbers? I don't know. Sweden has a lot of amazing music. As a matter of fact, too much music. And I said that in a good way. I say it lovingly. Like, mind you, I have covered several different countries here on this channel, but never on earth have I found such a freaking gold mine that where, like, no matter where I dig my hand in, I'm usually gonna either find a musician I already know, or that musician is already loved by millions and I, for some odd reason, have not discovered them. Like this next one. Apparently I knew one of the songs, but I had never heard the name of the group previously, but thankfully you guys suggested it down in the comment section, so I get to experience it. I know several of you would be expecting for me to put that one song, Dancing Queen, but I decided to choose something that I had not heard previously. So up next, we currently got Abba with the song Mamma Mia. Let's check it out. We're starting off with a guitar solo. This song says 80s all over it. I love it. Oh my lord. I can't. It's so different from that other song. But I love it though, it's interesting. Let's stop right there. All right. I love the fact that we make music videos to preserve how we once looked, the music that we once did, and everything, and apparently these people took it to the next level and became historical. I know you guys hold Abba as like one of your freaking gods over there in Sweden, and I can understand 100% why. They're like this pop rock group, and they have everything going for them. They got the piano, the keyboardist himself, with the guitar, and they got these two wonderful ladies,
singing. Not their heart outs, but I mean, they're definitely singing really well. To the point where they made this song a massive classic out in Sweden. And as a matter of fact, even the world. How did I not know it? I don't know. The moment that my editor slash producer, Kimfi Borska, if you guys did not know, here's a picture of her. She put together the list, and when she found out that Abba was from there, she's like,
I have to put this, I can't miss it.
When she saw the song Mamma Mia, she called out, she literally right across the room, she goes,
do you know what's Mamma Mia?
And I go, what's that? And that's how we got here. Dancing Queen, on the other hand, I knew by heart because I remember growing up and it was always on the radio. My dad listens to like this one specific radio. So whether we were at home or in his car, Dancing Queen was always playing. At this point, I honestly feel compelled by the gods of ABBA to give it a 10 out of 10. Which, by the way, I want to know if you or your mother had the opportunity to go see them live. Leave it down in the comment section. Alright, my friends, it looks like that. We have concluded our list. But thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate you sticking around. If you are not aware, here on this channel, we've covered all sorts of different things for Sweden, such as the landscapes, the metal community, and even some of your personal favorite snacks. So make sure you stick around to the end of this video so you could click on some of these other goodies. I've been having a lot of fun and getting the opportunity to talk back and forth with you guys all over the place, here in the comment section, out on Instagram, and even some of you on my P.O. box.
Wow, that was pretty smooth, Brian. How'd you do that?
Buttery slick.
I'm so weird.
Here at this P.O. box, you actually get the opportunity to send anything that your heart desires. You know one thing that I haven't gotten from Sweden, though? A postcard. And I love postcards. If any of you get the opportunity, that would be super freaking sweet and sick of you guys. I would definitely give you guys a shout out. Just please let me know if it's coming so I could expect it and go and check it. Otherwise, the mail lady is like,
when are you gonna pick up your crap?
My friends, I appreciate all the support. I have never done a part 5 for any country, but Sweden is one of the top runner-ups for me, the first part to part 5. But I would definitely love to hear your opinion as to what musicians you would like featured in part 5, if there were to be any. So make sure you leave your comments down below along with the name of the artist and your favorite song by them. And hey, maybe I'll see you soon. One last announcement before I head out. Several of you have been asking for a Eurovision version of Sweden. There was one once upon a time. Like I mentioned earlier in this video, YouTube has been a little bit like on the weird side and they've been taking down some of the most amazing videos that we've had to date here on this channel, and I'm very sad about that. But Sweden, since there's a lot of legendary music coming out of there, of course, I got my ass blocked. Let me know if you would be interested in me making a secondary part. Once again, I do have to go through YouTube regulations, and then the silly part is that they could still come back afterwards and be like, hey, we changed our mind. That song is now illegal. Everywhere. I just don't understand YouTube. How do you have a musician that's from Sweden, and yet you block their music in their home country of Sweden? Alright, my friends, I've been talking too much. Hasta la pasta, and I'll see you guys on the flip side. Bye!